Hello everyone. Welcome to the second part of the module Role of Emerging Technologies in Different Industries Part 2. I'm Dr. Prashant Raman. I have more than 12 years of experience, both in experience in academics and industry. I'm currently working at Institute of Public Enterprise, Hyderabad as assistant professor. Prior to this, I was associated with FMS-WISDOM, Banasthali Vidyapith, and Satyam Computer Services Limited, now known as Tech Mahindra, as relationship manager. In the first part of the module, we discussed about three technologies: artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, and big data. Now in the second part, we will be covering four emerging technologies: machine learning, augmented reality, virtual reality, and blockchain technology. So we begin this module with machine learning. Machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence which focuses mainly on machine learning from their experience and making predictions based on its experience. Arthur Samuel, a pioneer in the field of artificial intelligence and computer gaming, coined the term machine learning. He defined machine learning as a field of study that gives computers the capability to learn without being explicitly programmed. A simple way to explain machine learning is by taking the example of training of students during exam. While preparing for the exams, students don't actually cram the subject but try to learn it with complete understanding. Before the examination, they feed their machine, that is brain, with a good amount of high quality data, that is questions and answers from different books or teachers' notes or online video lectures, etc. Actually, they are training their brain with input as well as output. That is, what kind of approach or logic do they have to solve different kinds of questions. Each time they solve practice test papers and test their performance in terms of accuracy and score. Gradually, the performance of the students keeps on improving, thus gaining more confidence with the adopted approach. And that's how actually models are built: by training the machine with data, testing the machine with data, and checking the model scores by comparing its answers with the actual output, which was not fed during training. Let us now look at how machine learning is actually playing an important role in different domains. The first domain is financial services. Banks and other businesses in the financial industries use machine learning technology for two key purposes. First, to identify important insights in data, and second, to prevent fraud. The insights can identify investment opportunities or help investors know when to trade. With the help of data mining, the businesses can identify clients with high risk profiles and can also use cyber surveillance to locate warning signs of fraud. The next beneficiary of machine learning is government. Government agencies such as public safety and utilities have a particular need for machine learning, since they have multiple sources of data that can be mined for insights. Analyzing sensor data, for example, identifies ways to increase efficiency and saves money. Machine learning can also help detect fraud and minimize identity theft. The next area is healthcare. Machine learning is a fast-growing trend in the healthcare industry, thanks to the advent of wearable devices and sensors that can use data to assess a patient's health in real time. The technology can also help medical experts analyze data to identify trend or red flags that may lead to improved diagnosis and treatment. The next is retail industry. Websites recommending items you might like based on previous purchases are using machine learning to analyze your buying history. Retailers rely on machine learning to capture data, analyze it, and use it to personalize a shopping experience, implement a marketing campaign, price optimization, merchandise supply planning, and for customer insights. The use of machine learning is also seen in transportation industry. Analyzing data to identify patterns and trends is key to the transportation industry, which relies on making routes more efficient and predicting potential problems to increase profitability. The data analysis and modeling aspects of machine learning are important tools to delivery companies, public transportation, and other transportation organizations. The last but not the least is the oil and gas industry. Machine learning is helping the companies to find out new energy sources, analyzing minerals in the ground, predicting refinery sensor failures, and streamlining oil distribution to make it more efficient and cost effective. The number of machine learning use cases for different industries is vast and is still expanding. By now, you must have understood about what exactly is machine learning and the importance of it in different industries. Let us now dig deep and understand some of the specific applications of machine learning that we, as consumers, commonly use. The first one is traffic alerts, maps. Now, Google Maps is probably the app we generally use whenever we go out and require assistance in directions and traffic. An important feature of Google Maps is it actually suggests us alternate routes in case there is a heavy traffic on the usual route. But how does it know that? Well, it's a combination of people currently using the service, historic data of that route collected over time, and few other things. Everyone using maps is actually providing their location, average speed, the route in which they are traveling, etc., which in turn helps Google to collect massive data about the traffic. This makes it easy for Google Maps to predict the upcoming traffic and adjust the route according to it. The second interesting application of machine learning is in the online transportation network. If you have used an app to book a cab like Uber or Ola, etc., then you are already using machine learning to an extent. It provides a personalized application which is unique to you. It automatically detects your location and provides options to either go home or office or any other frequent places based on your history and patterns. When booking a cab, app estimates the price of the ride. Now, the important question is how to take care of the peak traffic and diversions, etc. The answer is machine learning. Jeff Schneider, working at Uber, in an interview mentions that they use machine learning to define price surge hours by predicting the rider demand. In the entire cycle of the services, machine learning plays a major role. The role of machine learning is immense in social media. One of the most common applications of machine learning is automatic friend tagging suggestions in Facebook or any other social media platform. Facebook uses face detection and image recognition to automatically find the face of the person which machines its database and hence suggests us to tag the person based on deepfake. Facebook's deep learning project Deepfake is responsible for the recognition of faces and identifying which person is in the picture. It also provides alternative tags to images already uploaded on Facebook. One of the most important contributions of machine learning is in Google Translate. Remember the time when you traveled to a new place and you find it difficult to communicate with the locals or finding local spots where everything is written in a different language? Well, Google's GNMT, Google Neural Machine Translation, is a neural machine language that works on thousands of languages and dictionaries, uses natural language processing to provide the most accurate translation of any sentence or words. Since the tone of the words also matters, it uses other techniques like POS tagging, part of speech, NER, named entity recognition, and chunking. It is one of the best and most used applications of machine learning. Machine learning is playing a crucial role in fraud detection. Experts predict online credit card fraud to rise to a massive $32 billion in 2020. That's something to worry about. Fraud detection is one of the most necessary applications of machine learning. For example, PayPal is using machine learning for protection against money laundering. The company uses a set of tools that helps them to compare millions of transactions taking place and distinguish between legitimate or illegitimate transactions between the buyers and the sellers. Another important application of machine learning is dynamic pricing. Setting the right price for a good or a service is an old problem in economic theory. There are a vast amount of pricing strategies that depend on the objective sought. But be it a movie ticket, a plane ticket, or cab fares, everything is dynamically priced. In recent years, machine learning has enabled pricing solutions to track buying trends and determine more competitive product prices. For example, if you're traveling in the festive season, the chances are that the flight prices will be twice the original price. The next emerging technology that we are going to discuss is virtual reality. Virtual reality is an artificial environment that is created with software and presented to the user in such a way that the user suspends belief and accepts it as a real environment. On a computer, virtual reality is primarily experienced through two of the five senses, sight and sound. When the term virtual reality comes to our mind, we think of a person wearing a wrap-around headset and data gloves, wired into a powerful workstation or supercomputer. What actually differentiates VR from an ordinary computer experience is the nature of input and output. Where an ordinary computer uses things like a keyboard, mouse, etc. for input, VR uses sensors that detect how your body is moving and where a PC displays output on a screen or a printer. VR uses multiple things like two screens, one for each eye, stereo or surround sound speakers, and maybe some form of haptics. That is nothing but touch and body perception, feedback as well. Let us now dive in and look at the applications of virtual reality in different industries. The first application of virtual reality is in marketing campaigns. While consumers are becoming more and more sophisticated and are looking for engaging, interactive, and personal experiences, marketers have to apply or employ heightened interactivity and increasingly personalized communications to impress their audiences. For digital marketers, virtual reality has enhanced the awareness among the users with features that create greater impact on the users. Virtual reality has transformed the world of media and marketing. Virtual reality headsets have taken the world by storm. There is an increase in the role of virtual reality in the healthcare sector. VR is increasingly being used as a diagnostic tool for various diseases, from mental conditions like schizophrenia, Alzheimer's disease, and traumatic brain surgery to eye conditions such as cataracts and glaucoma. In terms of planning, VR is helping physicians to prepare for surgeries, to determine how best to carry out procedures. Surgeons require realistic images of the patients, anatomical structures such as bones and tissues. Using these images, they can make more informed decisions about what course of action to take. The next sector that is harnessing the virtual reality technology is education and training. Virtual reality plays a significant role in the education field. It makes it easier for students to comprehend what they are being taught and also allows them to live the reality. It helps in introducing students to rather difficult concepts which are easily demonstrated through engrossed experiences. There are some concepts which educators find it hard to elaborate. This makes it hard for the students to understand. However, virtual reality enables them to understand the concept much easily by getting them to virtually live it. One of the fields where virtual reality has been adopted very quickly is in the military. VR is being put to use to different uses in the military. It is used to train soldiers in a simulated battlefield. This gives soldiers the opportunity to learn without the risk of being killed or injured. They can simulate many kinds of battlefield scenarios. All the scenarios include flight simulation, medical administration in the battlefield, virtual boot camps, etc. Virtual reality can also be used to treat post-traumatic stress. This triggers of the crisis can be simulated for the purpose of the treatment. When the patients are exposed to the triggers often, they will gradually get over the trauma. Then we have the real estate industry using the virtual reality technology. VR is used to view the plan of a building. This gives a three-dimensional image. Architects and developers upload all the virtual reality versions of the proposed buildings on their virtual reality database, and their prospective clients can view the structures from there. It is just like viewing structures that are yet to be built. Estate agents can also upload the virtual or real images of real homes to be sold. So instead of taking the prospective clients to different locations, they can just view them through virtual reality head-mounted display units from the comfort of their homes or offices. It saves a lot of time, effort, and money for both the prospective customers and the agents. Another industry that is harnessing the potential of virtual reality is automobile manufacturing. Ford, a popular automobile giant, has already embraced virtual reality in the process of manufacturing vehicles. Prototypes of any proposed vehicle is uploaded on the virtual reality platform where several engineers can view and make necessary recommendations before the actual vehicle is manufactured. This saves a lot of money, time and effort. The vehicle is only produced when all the engineers are satisfied with the virtual prototype. Plans are already in top gear to incorporate virtual reality technology in Toyota's manufacturing process. Aviation industry has very much appreciated the virtual reality technology. VR is being used to simulate a flying experience to train and test trainee pilots. Every pilot has to pass the simulation test several times before he can fly a real plane. The simulation feels like flying a plane in the air. This is one of the oldest applications of virtual reality. The next technology that we are going to discuss is augmented reality. Augmented reality, AR, is a type of interactive reality-based display environment that takes the capabilities of computer-generated display, sound, text, and effects to enhance the user's real-world experience. Augmented reality combines real and computer-based scenes and images to deliver a unified but enhanced view of the world. One of the most popular means by which AR has entered into our everyday life is through mobile games. In 2016, the AR game Pokemon Go became a sensation worldwide, with over 100 million estimated users at its peak. According to Forbes, the game ended up making more than $2 billion. The game allowed the users to see Pokemon characters bouncing around in their own towns. The goal was to capture these pocket monsters, then use them to battle others locally in AR gyms. Let us now look at the role of augmented reality in different industries. The first one is retail. Augmented reality has created a new experience both for offline and online shopping. Virtual fitting rooms help users choose the right size and color so that the product returns can be reduced. In a similar way, choosing a new car or a new furniture for your apartment can also be easily done through AR. The next is manufacturing. AR can facilitate and accelerate the building processes at the factory. Project managers can monitor work progress in real time through AR markers on equipment. Besides, it can save a ton of time using digital maps and plants. Pointing a device into location shows how the pieces of machine will fit the final construction. Next is education and training. AR in education brings truly unlimited possibilities for teaching and learning processes. In many cases, theoretical knowledge is not enough. To obtain proper skills in professional areas, students of technical faculties especially need practice and hands-on experience in these areas. AR can help perform a virtual practice with augmented tutorials, digital modeling, and simulations. Now, medical students can try their first surgeries without injuring patients, and future astronauts can get ready for the next space mission. Then we have the travel and tourism industry. GPS mobile apps with AR can show tourists routes and directions to desirable destinations, translates the sign on the street, give information about sightseeing, etc. Some companies within the travel industry are developing augmented reality apps, which allow tourists to enhance physical locations and tourist attractions. This may allow a user to point their smartphone at a building or a landmark and learn more about it in real time. For example, a user may point their phone at a restaurant and instantly be provided with reviews or menus, or aim their tablet at a historic landmark and be presented with information about its history. Let us now look at some of the specific applications of augmented reality. An interesting application of AR can be seen in a flight journey. At the flight counter, the most frequently asked question among the travelers is, "Will this luggage fit in the overhead space in the cabin?" With the help of the AR app, you can easily measure the dimensions of your handbag and avoid any embarrassing moments. While during the flight, with the help of AR, you can easily find your seat in the cabin. It's also possible to check where you are flying right now. Soon after you have landed in a new country, you come out of a plane and now you don't know where to go. With the help of AR maps, you will be able to find the taxi stand or a bus stop or other useful information while you are walking at the airport. Marketers are using AR to enhance the shopping experience for the customers. AR makes the searching of an item very realistic and easy. instead of making consumer use the old way to write keywords in the search box to search for the item, the consumers can now utilize the device camera to make the shopping experience more effortless. With the help of an AR app, the device camera scans the image in the real time and finds the item online. Another great application of AR is the virtual try-on experience. Whenever a consumer finds a new product, they want to try it. Trying is especially important for apparel and fashion products, such as eyewear, because people want to know whether the product works for them or not. It can be tiring for the consumers shopping at the stores to try out the different products again and again. Also, if you are shopping online, then trying out products becomes even more challenging. Using AR, it's possible to significantly reduce the number of times when people have to try on the items in the dressing room. You can simply use the technology and admire the different looks altogether. Another application of AR is in enhancing the education system. The environment around us provides countless opportunities for education. I will just share a few examples of how we can improve the process of learning. First is learning anatomy. Learning human anatomy from book is quite tedious and cumbersome. You look at pictures and have to imagine how they are reflected in reality. Using AR, you can now scan a body part of yourself or a friend with your phone and explore the details of human anatomy. The second is getting rid of the paper manuals. Nobody likes reading a manual before a product. Consumers want to use the product as soon as they buy it. AR is being used to provide an interactive guide in a real-world environment. AR helps guide the customers on how to interact with the device for the very first time. The last technology that we are going to discuss in this module is blockchain technology. The blockchain is an incredible invention. Since its inception, it has evolved into something greater. And the main question everyone is asking is, what is blockchain technology and what are its applications in different industries? By allowing digital information to be distributed but not copied, blockchain technology created the backbone of a new type of internet. Originally devised for digital currency Bitcoin, the tech community has now found the other potential uses for this technology. In this section, I'm going to explain to you what is blockchain technology, what are its properties, and its role in different domains. A blockchain is, in the simplest term, a time-stamped series of irreversible record of data that is managed by a cluster of computers not owned by any single entity. Each of these blocks of data are secured and bound to each other using cryptographic principles, that is, chain. The three main properties of blockchain technology which has helped it gain widespread acclaim are as follows. First is decentralization, second transparency, and third immutability. The blockchain network has no central authority. Since it is a shared and an immutable ledger, the information in it is open for anyone and everyone to see. Hence, anything that is built on the blockchain is by its very nature transparent, and everyone involved is accountable for their actions. A simple way to understand the concept of blockchain technology is like, think of booking a railway ticket. We buy the tickets on an app or on the web. The credit card companies take a commission for processing the transaction. With blockchain, not only can the railway operator save on credit card processing fees, it can move the entire ticketing process to the blockchain. The two parties in the transactions are the railway company and the passenger. The ticket is a block which will be added to a ticket blockchain. Just as a monetary transaction on blockchain is a unique, independently verifiable record, so can your ticket be. The key here is this: it's free. Not only can the blockchain transfer and store money, but it can also replace all processes and business models which rely on charging a small fee for a transaction or any other transaction between two parties. Let us look at some of the applications of blockchain technology. Like the internet, social media, and mobile before, blockchain technologies represent a significant opportunity for companies to reduce the cost of marketing operations, create more unique customer experiences, build improved customer relationships, and reduce corporate risk. The first application of blockchain technology is how to reach and target the right audience. If we consider the online advertising industry, about 70% of the advertisers failed to target the consumers with the behavioral data, and over in a 1,000 ads gets clicked in an online display ad campaign. The point here is, marketers have consumer data and pay exorbitant fees to the middlemen involved in advertising, but even then are unable to engage the target audience. So how to get the right audience to see your ad and then get them to engage with it? Blockchain technology offers a solution. Organizations like BitClave have reached a whole new level of innovation and utilize blockchain's properties to create a decentralized search engine that helps advertisers get in front of the target audience. The impressive fact is, they even compensate the target audience in the form of CAT tokens for providing their personal data to the advertisers. So every time someone clicks on ads on the BitClave search engine, they get paid. This increases the hyper-targeting of ads, and people see only those ads that have stated interest in. Thus, blockchain and its tremendous power to decentralize can truly solve the customer engagement and targeting factor in the advertising industry. The next is, blockchain technology is helping in avoiding ad frauds. Ad frauds in the marketing industry is becoming a serious issue for advertisers. Paying for fake clicks and impressions has become a common phenomenon today. It was found that in January 2017 alone, one in every pay-per-click was fraudulent. Forrester reports that as much as 56% of all display ad dollars were lost to fraudulent inventory in 2016, and the cost of ad fraud globally is expected to increase $50 billion over the next decade. Ad fraud is not only emptying the pockets of marketers, but also distorting their analytical data, which is ultimately affecting their strategic decisions. Blockchain can make data-driven marketing more transparent by validating and analyzing each consumer's journey through verified ad delivery, confirming that a real person saw the ad and as per the specifics of a media contract. Marketers will be able to control how their assets are delivered by monitoring exactly where their ads are being placed, alleviating ad fraud from the automated bots by ensuring that real followers and consumers are engaging with their ads, and ensuring proper ad engagement tracking that will lead to more precise digital attribution. Companies like BitTeaser and AdChain have already disrupted PPC advertising using this technique. The next is the role of blockchain technology in disrupting the loyalty programs and reward system. A customer never forgets when he has made to feel special. That's why loyalty programs work so well with sales. So how can marketers use blockchain technology to create an amazing experience for their customers? A gift card can rest upon the blockchain and become a safe platform for issuing and maintaining gift cards and loyalty programs. Frequently, customers accumulate several gift cards and don't get to use them because either the card has a few amount of money left or doesn't buy something they find useful. So the result is all the money goes down the drain and creates a bad consumer experience. This gap can be filled using blockchain technology, converting the gift cards into digital coins, valets, allowing customers to redeem them. Better yet, combine different coupons, gift cards, etc., and redeem them in a single transaction. Companies like Sense and Orion Coin have successfully used this concept to save millions of dollars that go to waste in gift cards. Another example of loyalty programs leveraging blockchain technology is Gift, which is a public ledger that makes exchanging and redeeming gift cards hassle-free. The next is decentralization of e-commerce. Who would have anticipated that blockchain would one day decentralize the way you buy things online? Platforms like Open Bazaar make use of blockchain technology to create a decentralized marketplace wherein vendors can sell their items directly to customers without needing to pay third-party platform fees. It also has a built-in Bitcoin wallet that helps to pay and earn cryptocurrency. And last but not the least, disrupting influencer marketing. Brands these days have realized that the target audience are more inclined to believe what people are saying about their brand rather than what the brand is saying about itself. According to Thomson Survey 2018, 59% of the marketers are planning to increase their influencer marketing budgets in the coming year. A company called Pattern is already working on this capability, aiming to help brands verify an influencer's value by tracing and recording their social information via blockchain. Leveraging blockchain's transparency and immutability, these platforms are helping marketers solve the issues such as authenticating the identity of an influencer, validating their followers, getting a guarantee on ROI with the help of smart contracts wherein the payment can be held in escrow until the desired output has been achieved by the influencers. So by looking at all these examples and applications of all the emerging technologies, we will be witnessing a very dynamic period in the technology space. In the next 5 years, these technologies will be gaining more relevance and demand for them is going to rise sharply. As competition continues to grow, companies will be looking out for innovative ways to improve their strategies. And this is where the whole role of technologies, such as emerging technologies, will come into play. With this, we have reached the end of this two-part module. I hope the two modules would have given you some insights on the importance of the new technologies and how these technologies are helping different industries and also the end user to make their job easier. Thank you. Yeah.